One nation, one election. Sounds appealing, isn't it? Well, my friends, the grass looks greener on the other side. Elections in India are a carnival of democracy. The method in which elections are to be conducted holds utmost importance. Dr. Qureshi quotes, "Elections are necessary evil." The concept of simultaneous election is not new in India. The first election conducted in 1952 was held simultaneously in Lok Sabha and State Assembly until 4th Lok Sabha, which liquidated early. Then why did parliamentary government change this policy? A basic question at this point arises: if this policy is really so cost effective, so time efficient, then why? Why wasn't it a success in that era? Moreover, this policy will only serve the interests of those bent on further centralization of an already overly centralized union, thus gravely affecting the federal character of our nation. Our Prime Minister, Mr. Narendra Modi, and the Bharatiya Janata Party have supported the idea of simultaneous election. However, the ground reality is that its implementation will require a number of changes to our constitution, which is neither fixed nor flexible, but a combination of both. Article 83, dealing with duration of Houses of Parliament. Article 85, dissolution of Lok Sabha by President. Article 172, duration of state legislature. Article 174, dissolution of state assembly. And Article 356, President's rule. All have to be changed. Studies show election commission spends approximately rupees 8,000 crores on election in a time period of around 5 years. In a country like India, with around 600 million voters, this amount is not huge at all. In fact, a nominal expenditure of rupees 27 per voter is spent. Should India be more mindful about it? And of course, imagine an anti-democratic policy being executed in one of the largest democratic nations, for a simple reason that after its execution, national issues will be focused more. Regional parties will get marginalized even after having a reasonable manifesto. And the list goes on. For now, I rest my case upon you all to ponder. Thank you.